In part four of Teaching Bullet, we go on a drive to a place that he's never been before. We do an old track, a long track in this new location so that we can evaluate where we are. We now have all the information we need to finish training over the summer and get back to you guys closer to deer season. Here's Bullet. We are going to do a 672-yard track that is 4 hours old and is a deer hoof dragged. I dragged it because I was adding so much time and distance. Come on. And the start is right here. Find it, Bullet. Boy. Find it. Find it. What's in the poop? Wind is coming my left to right, so uphill. Made it. Never mind the cars. No poop. Leave it. Leave it. Good boy. Good. Good boy. The wind has now shifted and it's right in our face, so that's better. No poop. Good boy. Good boy.
My phone may shut off halfway through this video as usual, but I'm gonna give it a whirl. Don't get tangled up. Good boy, good boy. Good boy. No poop. Turkey poop. Good boy. No poop. Good boy. Find it. Something scary. Find it, buddy. Never mind. Thank you. Good boy. I don't know what's scary. Good boy. There, good. Good boy. Good boy. Come on. There you go. We've never been here before, and he's all scared. Come on. Jack actually crosses the brook and runs up the opposite side. So. He's not wrong, he's just on the wrong side of the brook. Come on. Try to find it. Good job. Good boy. Good. He's never seen a tree this big. Let's see what happens. Yes, good boy. Get it, get it, get it, buddy. Yes, good boy. This thing is huge. I can barely get over it. Oh. We drove to this location and he has never been in these woods ever. Which is what a tracking dog is going to be, in a new woods every time. Leave it. Leave it. Leave it. Come on. Leave the poop. Leave it. Okay. Good boy. Let's go. Good boy. Good boy. Come on. Somebody, find it. Find it. boy. Find it. Find it. I don't see anything. Come on, find it. Find it. Come on, buddy, you can find it. Find it, buddy. He's off the track, and I am intentionally letting him find it again. Come on, buddy, find it. Hang on, buddy, I'm stuck. Alright, we're all untangled again. Phew. You want to go out there? That's pretty gross. Now that we're untangled, let's see if we can get back on track again. Boy. Oh, don't get tangled up again. Wait. One tangle per track is enough. Boy. boy. Anybody? Somebody. Good boy. Good. Come on, you're good. This is very dry down vegetation. Don't second guess yourself, you were doing good. Good boy. Oh, I know this stuff sucks. Go ahead. You gotta learn to push through. Yes, there's people yelling. It's all right. Boy. Come on, bud. Never mind the people. Come on. Back over here and find it again. Good boy, you found it. Good boy. I can't believe my phone hasn't shut off yet. Yes, nice job. He overshot that corner. Recognized right away that he overshot the corner and turned around. Where'd it go? Oh, goodness. Oh, almost fell in. Yes, nice job. That's good. Find it. We're almost there. Don't get tangled up. Wait. Yay, you did it! That was a super hard track. Yeah, I know, I tied it to the tree so a coyote wouldn't take it. Good boy! Nice job! Good boy.
This was a pretty hard track for Bullet, in addition to being his first 4-hour-old track. There was 2-3 places where he was really afraid, And I'm pretty sure it was a coyote because there was a couple piles of fresh coyote poop that hadn't been there when I laid the track. He did get off track once. I let him work it out, and he did pretty good. It took him a while to work that out. We got tangled up, had to take a break, get untangled. Then towards the end, he got really distracted by people yelling across the road, and I did help him get back on track at that point. But overall, he did super well, and we'll have a lot of things to work on through the summer, and I look forward to giving you our next episode.